Welcome back, friends. In this video tutorial, we'll be talking about the Streptococcus species, and we'll be talking about several types of Streptococcus. In this first video, we'll be talking about the introductory part about the Streptococcus bacteria. Now, Streptococcus, as the term suggests, coccus, it means they are consisting of the spherical shaped bacteria, right? So they are spherical bacteria. So let me write, they are spherical in nature, right? So they are spherical in nature, and obviously they are gram positive. So they are gram positive in nature. Okay, so they are gram positive spherical shaped bacteria. That means they are cocci, right? So we can write that they are cocci or cocci, whatever. Now in this case of coccus, what we know that the Streptococcus, it should look like something like that, right? So it's a spherical shaped bacteria. Now in under the microscope, we never find bacteria separately placed like that. Instead, they are attached with each other to make a chain like structure like that, right? It's a chain, it's a bacterial chain like that. Okay, now we can find the Streptococcus often like that. Okay, and these are also free living bacteria. So let me write this property also. They are also free living, so no confusion about that, free living bacteria. Okay, now among the Streptococcus, there are certain species which are very much important. Now the one of the most important species among all is Streptococcus pyogenes. Streptococcus pyogenes, or pyogenes, pyogenes. This is going to cause severe diseases in human beings, so that's why this is medically important. Except for that, there are Streptococcus bovis. So let me write the names: Streptococcus bovis, b-o-v-i-s. Then there are Streptococcus mutans, and obviously there are Streptococcus pneumoniae, which is a causative agent for pneumonia, right? Pneumoniae. So just focus on the spelling for the bacteria, and all of them are scientific names, so you should put underline in all these cases. Okay, I am not putting here for lack of time. Okay, now these are the different types of Streptococcus. Among them, this one states tool, because Streptococcus pyogenes is a very dangerous agent. Now the Streptococcus pyogenes is a very dangerous because they can cause severe diseases, right? Now the Streptococcus pyogenes usually cause diseases with the help of a protein which is called a M protein. So it is having something called M protein. Now, using this M protein, the Streptococcus pyogenes can cause infections in human being. Now if I provide you the structure of the Streptococcus pyogenes, what is going to be the structure of Streptococcus pyogenes? Simply is it is telling us that something like that. So it is having a cell wall, and so let me draw the cell walls or cell membrane first. So if this is the cell membrane, for example, this is the cell membrane. Now let's draw the cell wall, and let's take this color. Okay, this one. This is the cell wall, for example, and outside the cell wall there is a capsule. And here we go, the capsule, and throughout all this place there are, so let me draw, this is the M protein, for example. This M protein will have a structure like that. Say this is M protein coming out like this. Now obviously from other side another round of M protein is coming out. This is another round of M protein, right? So this blue colored protein here is the M protein of Streptococcus. Okay, and it is embedded through this cell wall system, and as it is embedding, this particular terminal here, this terminal E, is called C terminal of this protein, and this is N terminal of that protein. Okay, and it is embedded, right? And in this case, this particular protein, this M protein, is the major virulent factor. This is the major virulent factor for the Streptococcus pyogenes bacteria. Okay, and what they can do, that they can trigger immune response, they can trigger different chemical toxins or cytotoxins, they can kill cells, right? And the unique feature about all the Streptococcus species, different types of Streptococcus species, that some of them are hemolytic, right? Some of them are hemolytic. Hemolytic. Now, what do we mean by hemolytic? As the term suggests, heme means definitely it is something to do with red blood cell, right? So hemolytic means it can, so it means it can degrade red blood cell, right? So that's what I mean by hemolytic. Now in this case, what we can see that if we plate this Streptococcus bacteria in blood agar, so let us take this one. So if this is the agar or petri plate, for example, now here we are having the blood agar coming out. So let's draw the blood agar in this case, put it here. Okay, so here we are having the blood agar. Now here somewhere, if we start, so we inoculate this particular thing with our Streptococcus, after delivering some time, it will generate colonies like that. See, it will generate colonies like that. So here it is, colonies will be formed like that, which will be surrounded by the white zone, or sometimes colonies are also produced surrounded by this green colored zone in blood agar. So this kind of thing can be seen in this case. Now this white zone formation can be explained because this Streptococcus is hemolytic, so it lies down all the red blood cells that are surrounding that particular colony. So the colonies that give rise, so let me draw the colonies. I am drawing the colonies with this color. So colonies are developed, and during this development of colonies, they are degrading certain position or certain number of red blood cells surrounding that colony, and it is creating this particular white ring surrounding that colony, right? So this is a typical characteristic. So it's a typical colony pattern, typical colony pattern for Streptococcus species that we can observe, right? But not all the Streptococcus are hemolytic. One of the example of the hemolytic Streptococcus is this Streptococcus pyogenes. Again, this is a example of hemolytic Streptococcus. Okay, and another thing is that this is one way of identifying Streptococcus. Obviously, there are other ways, like this is catalase positive, and also there is a test called latex kit test. So let me write, this test is called latex kit test. Now this latex kit test, what we can do, that there are latex beads or small latex particles out there. Now if we put the small latex particle and along with the bacterial culture, now if it is a Streptococcus, in those cases what it will do, it will agglutinate those latex. So let me draw this structure for you. So if, let's say, these are the latex particles, so we provide the latex particles there. Now if, and what we provide, we also provide the bacterial culture. So let me write, culture is also provided here. Now after that, results can be obtained. One result is that all of these latex particles will agglutinate with one another, and on the other hand, another result can be there where they will be separated without being agglutinated. So if the second position occurs, in those cases, what it provides us, a dark white, or it's a bright white solution, and in this case it won't provide anything. It shows, and this agglutination means its taste is positive, and unagglutination or non-agglutination means the taste is negative. Now positive taste means there is, that the bacterial culture we use is of Streptococcus, right? So if this thing occurs, I will be telling that yes, the culture we use is eventually Streptococcus. If it never results, if it is not resulting in this kind of agglutination, then what we can say, that yes, whatever culture we have used definitely is not Streptococcus. Okay, so that's how we can actually identify the different types of Streptococcus. And actually, depending upon their serological means, we can also divide them into several different sections, different serotypes actually, like alpha, beta, and all these things. I am not talking about them in this particular video, but these Streptococcus are important because they are clinically significant and they can cause severe different types of infections. And we'll be seeing it in the later video. Thank you.